I have one story that I've been telling my entire life. It's the only joke that I've been able to tell for over 20 years. It's just this one joke that I have. And with all the random facts that I can recall that I shouldn't be able to recall, like the Wilhelm scream, if you know that, over 400 TV shows and movies feature the Wilhelm scream. I mean, X-Files, Indiana Jones, Star Wars, Game of Thrones, all of that feature the Wilhelm scream. I will always remember that. But only one joke. Upon all the other facts, like the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. Of course, I don't know what that means, but it's seared into my memory. It is in here forever. Yeah, but for better or worse, my brain only allows for that one joke to be there forever. And don't get me wrong, like, I mean, I read a lot of jokes. I love jokes. I love humor. I even follow a lot of those joke of the day pages. I read funny ones all the time. Like, I mean, there was one that I just read the other day that was incredibly funny, but I can't remember it. I'll also say I had this one joke, and that's okay with me. It's been with me for over 2 decades, and I love that. It's been with me from elementary school until now, through relationships, loss, success, embarrassment, that time at Story Slam that I announced that I was running for city council and then didn't. It's been with me forever, and it's kind of nice, and it's grown and it's changed. I've grown and changed so much, but also this joke has grown and changed a lot. In my 20s, I started serving in restaurants, and that can be a really demeaning and distressing type of job. People really try to tear you down. They don't have any kind of respect for service workers, even if you're really good at it. And that can be very bad for certain people who can't deal with it. But for me, my little defense mechanism was some like playful sarcasm, and mixed in with some humor and some confusion and sometimes being a little bit of an asshole. But still, with the utmost importance put on giving quality service to my customers. So that bold personality that I've developed in that time has really helped me keep sane while serving at restaurants. I still do it to this day. But throwing customers off kilter a little bit, it's kind of fun to see, but of course, leaving them with a high quality experience. So for example, with this personality that I've developed, someone will ask what the soup of the day is. And of course, you have to gauge the table, the vibe there, before you decide to move forward with this. But they'll say, oh, what's the soup of the day? And I'll say, well, that's none of your business. Immediately following, I say, oh, I'm just joking, soup of the day is yada yada, and I'd go on and give them all the details of the soup that they could ever hope for. I mean, more information you'd ever want to know about a soup than possible. But in that moment, in that tiny little moment, after I say, that's none of your business, they question me as a server. They question how good I am, if I'm an asshole. But they also question how good of a customer they are. Like, did they just say something that was rude? Maybe they did, maybe they didn't. But overall, that little piece of time between me giving them, oh, I'm just kidding and all that, that leads to a great experience of mutual respect between me as a server and them as a customer, and it also leads to a 20% tip, which is the most important thing. Yeah, but it's been really great developing that type of mentality of some confusion, some awkwardness, a bit of being an asshole as well. But the joke that I mentioned that I've had for over 2 decades, and I really wanted to get there sooner, but I had to also explain like my experience of developing this. So the joke, a bear walks into a bar, and I should note that this bar is a drinking establishment. It's not like a literal bar. That's not a funny joke. This is a funny joke. So a bear does not walk into a literal bar. Bear walks into a drinking establishment. Bear walks into a bar. Also, I should have mentioned that I'm going to need you to suspend disbelief. This bear can talk. This bear can also go into a bar. But also a little piece of information to keep in mind for later in the joke is that this bear is thirsty. Okay, I'll start again. So a bear walks into a bar. He goes up to a bartender and he says, I'll have a Coke and... a water. Now see what I did there? That silence is where the magic happens. During that time, people look at me, which I saw some of you, look at me like I'm crazy. And that is so much fun. That's the fun of it. During that time, I've went literal minutes not doing that. For the sake of you guys, I did not. But I've went minutes. I've went on to do other tasks and come back just to deliver the punchline out of nowhere. And it's just, it's the best. So the punchline. So bear, bar, Coke, ... water. So the bartender says, why the big pause? The bear goes, they've been like this my whole life. Thank you.